So if you guys are anything like me, when you're lurking around the interwebs, you know, with intent, checking out bass players on YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, or maybe sometime in the future watching a bass player at a real life gig when we're allowed out back in the wild, you might want to, or you probably will want to, be able to tell quickly whether the bass player is a badass or not. So in this video, I'm going to share 5 ways that you can instantly tell whether a bass player is hot or not. Hey, it's Scott Devine here from scottsbasslessons.com, helping you take your bass playing to the next level. And on this channel, we focus on one thing and one thing only. The bass.
Really?
Oh yeah. I slapped the bass big time.
We do YouTube tutorials, we talk about gear, video essays focused on your favorite bass players, and everything in between. So if you are new here, if you're a newbie, make sure that you hit that subscribe button below. Now let's look at the ways that you can tell if a bass player is hot or not. Number one is the ability to move the position of their plucking hand for tonal variations on the fly. So many bass players are guilty of having their plucking hands glued in one place. You'll know if you're one of them, and I'm sure you've experienced it. Your thumb is always in the same place every time you play the bass. For many people, it's gonna be like glued on top of one of the pickups, and if you ever move it, it feels super uncomfortable, right? I'm sure that you know if you are one of these players. A true badass bass player can freely move the position of their plucking hand up and down the strings to get many different tonal variations. So check out this clip of the great Jaco Pastorius demonstrating this technique beautifully. Now notice where he's plucking his hand is, right over that bridge pickup, right? That tight sound. Now look where his plucking hand is, right over the neck pickup, and listen to the tone. Much rounder and fatter and plummier. Now, and then he went straight back to the bridge pickup as well. Now he's on the neck pickup again. Now he's on the bridge pickup again. So if you want a way to practice this, all you need to do is focus on the 3 primary positions of the plucking hand that you can use. Over the bridge pickup, over the neck pickup, and over the neck. Over the bridge pickup, it's going to sound like this. Over the neck pickup, and over the neck, much softer, right? And then you can get everywhere in between, but just make sure that everything that you're playing, you can do it here, you can do it here, and you can do it here. Number 2 is having complete control of dynamic range within their lines. Another thing that many bass players are guilty of is playing with no dynamic range or variation within their bass lines. Now, I'm not talking about being able to play loud in one part of the song and quiet within another part of the song. I'm actually talking about adjusting your dynamic range within the line itself. So certain notes are louder and certain notes are quieter, and it's all done on the fly as part of your musical expression. Now, to give you a great example of this, I want to show you a video of a good friend of mine, an epic bass player, Mitch Friedman. And when you're listening to this clip, I really want you to listen out for how all the hills and valleys within the groove, and notice that some notes really stick out and some notes are kind of just there in the background creating the groove, you know, for all of the rest of the vibe to lie on top of. Check this out. Mitch, by the way, you are a killing bass player, my friend. Straight away. It's like little melodies within the groove. Now when Mitch was playing, you'll have heard the hills and valleys within the lines. It wasn't It wasn't that. It was more. You know, just sort of like that. It's got that going on, okay? You've got to get it into your playing. Now, to do that, finger independence exercises are the key. All you need to do to work on this is just take groupings of three, okay, on one note, okay? One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. Okay, and you're accenting the one of every grouping. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. Now do fours, okay? One, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. Now do fives. One, two, three, four, five, one, two, three, four, five, one, two, three, four, five, one, two, three, four, five. Now when you speed it up, it's gonna sound like this. Threes. Fours. Fives. Okay, and what that's doing is giving you complete control over the individual fingers of your plucking hand so you can grab those dynamics when you want and need them. So next up is number three, and it is articulations are part of their musical voice. So articulations are like things like hammer-ons, pull-offs, vibratos, slides, ghost notes, stings, etc., right? Basically how you shape a note. Badass bass players have the ability to use articulations on the fly as part of their musical voice. For example, if you've ever heard a bass player or a guitar player and you know exactly who it is, even without seeing them, you can tell who it is, right? Like partly you can do that because of note choice, but also a big part of it is their articulations, which is, you know, which ones, which articulations are their flavor and how much they use them. So I'm gonna play a simple bass line for you. In the first example, I'm gonna use no articulations at all. And in the second example, I'm going to use articulations to give it a whole different vibe. So here's the bass line with no articulations. Now, with articulations. Now, number four, they use the entire register of the instrument. There is no dusty end. Now, I know I'm gonna get some heat for this, as some of you will feel that bass players need to be bass players and only play below the fifth fret. But in general, badass bass players use the entire range of the instrument. To demonstrate, let's take a look at somebody who is known for being a great bass player, Michael League, playing, obviously, a fantastic bass line. Instrument here. These lines would be impossible if he wasn't. Look at the fingerboard on this thing. Woo. Yeah. Now he's down the bottom. Now, I've got one more for you, but before that, question of the day. In terms of getting your bass playing to the next level, what is your biggest struggle on the bass right now? If you let me know in the comments, that would be amazeballs, because I'll be able to geek out over your answers and then create specific content for you focusing on what you're struggling with right now. So go ahead and let me know in the comments. Now, last but not least, it's number five. And number five is that they can play seamlessly in multiple different genres of music. Now, I know you're not gonna be able to spot this on the gig so much, but I thought it was really important to add this in, as I see so many bass players pigeonholing themselves as a particular type of bass player, when in reality the greats, you know, the badass bass players, they can all play in multiple styles of music and fully understand how the bass functions within the band within each particular style. For example, let's look at these various clips of Pino Palladino, arguably one of the most successful bass players of all time, and as you'll quickly see, he's certainly not pigeonholed. First up, we've got him with The Who. Put a crispy octave pedal on. Sliding thirds. Now next up we've got Pino playing with D'Angelo, and obviously many of you will already know that Pino played on that amazing album, the D'Angelo album, Voodoo, one of the most important albums of the genre, right? So check him out here with D'Angelo. Next up, we've got him with the John Mayer Trio. Does it get any better? One of the favourite bands I've seen him playing recently, Nine Inch Nails, and just huge fan of Trent Reznor. Don't know if you guys have checked the stuff that he did with Trent out, but man, it's killing. Playing his Music Man fretless on this. So good. And then finally, where it all began, with obviously Paul Young, Wherever I Lay My Hat. Now, if you've enjoyed the content in this video, make sure that you smash that like button below. But before you even go anywhere, I've also got two more super cool things for you, and both are free. First up is my completely free bass players toolkit that you can grab over at scottsbasslessons.com. It includes loads of free video resources, like my guide to dialing in the perfect bass tone and how you should approach it. Also, how to finally understand the modes and get rid of all of that confusion that you might have, and a ton of other cool stuff as well. Actually, it's got a video guide of how to set up your bass as well. And secondly, is a totally free 14-day trial for scottsbasslessons.com, which is the ultimate learning platform for bass players just like you. Scotts Bass Lessons has the largest and frankly coolest video course library on the planet, and is essentially your chance to study with the best bass players on the planet from the comfort of your own home. Does it get any better? The links for both of those things are down below in the description, so check them out if you wanna. And with that said, take it easy, and as always, I'll see you in the shed.